the shores of the Forth, central Scotland. Winding its way along the beachfront is part of a 134-mile long adventure, the John Muir Way. Passing through old and bustling forests, filled with all manner of creatures. And along the shoreline, punctuated by great tidal mudflats, the air echoing with the eerie calls of its unusual inhabitants. So come with me as I explore and meet some of the creatures of the John Muir Way. The adventure begins in the shadow of the great Forth bridges. The chunky, bolt-pimpled old Forth Road Bridge, still standing strong, but now showing its age. Meanwhile, the modern, sleekly styled Queensferry crossing, still gleaming and unblemished, basks in the warm morning sunlight. Its legs being tickled by the cold blue waters of the Forth. With the steel and concrete behind me, I wandered along the winding road into the trees. The waves lapped gently against the shore alongside, and the invigorating smell of the sea filled my nostrils. A gentle stroll along the shoreline, taking in the sights and absorbing the sounds. The first waypoint of the day approached, Hopetoun House. A 144-acre estate along the northern shores of West Lothian. Surrounded by beautiful old woodlands. The blue waters of the shipyards providing the backdrop for the trees' earthly tones. Skirting around the edges of the estate, catching glimpses of what lies at its heart. Hopetoun House, a grand 17th century stately residence, home to Lord Hopetoun. It's also the primary residence of a less civilised, boisterous bunch. Roaming the grounds amongst the elderly trees, these deer are certainly living the high life. I headed down into the woodland. Telltale signs of springtime were starting to show. The snowdrops were beginning to bloom. And the wildlife were going about their business in the canopy above. A small beach runs alongside. Not golden sands as you might imagine, but of broken shells and black pebbles, worn smooth by the power of the elements. It's a noisy little neighbourhood. The long-beaked curlews, perched at water's edge, amongst the worst offenders. Always causing a ruckus. The oyster catchers next door were dead to the world, snoozing away. Others have more important business to take care of. A redshank, more concerned with finding some breakfast than the antics of its neighbours. searching for some peace and quiet, you might try to seek solace amongst the trees, but this forest is filled with budding musicians. Drummer of the forest, the woodpecker. Taking a rest after a hard studio session, while his rival continues his beat. Number one in the forest single charts belongs to this stylish little character. This song thrush. Its complex melody echoing amongst the bark. While others are just happy nibbling away. The eastern skyline is dominated by the iconic shapes of steel and concrete. The bridges ever busy with traffic. To the west across the mudflats, the brick and stone of old, in the form of Blackness Castle, perched on the edge of the rocks. Constructed in the 15th century, it was once the main port for the borough of Linlithgow. It's been many things over the years, from a port to a prison, to the central ammunition depot for Scotland. And more recently, as a historical monument. It's also a popular location for TV and film. Well worth a wee visit. Pushing on, I passed through the bustling seaside town of Blackness, where I had to stop and have a little chuckle at this door. Leaving the castle and the town behind, I advanced westward. It was a busy old day out here on the shores of the Forth. The first warm sunshine of the year, after a particularly dark winter for many. Across the other side of the Firth, the Ochil Hills, shrouded in haze. I felt a great longing to be walking through those mountains again. The best thing about a coastal walk is that there's always plenty to see. From all the boat paraphernalia to fragments of the past. The solitary chimney is all that remains of Longannet coal power station. I had reached Bowness Harbour. The sea raising its hackles at the stormy weather now blowing in. It's the first time I've visited Bowness, another lovely wee coastal town on the Forth. I followed the railway line a little further west, past the Kinneil Foreshore Nature Reserve, before turning south to cross the railway line. Another extravagant home lay at the end of a long road. Kinneil House. It seems like the nobles of old enjoy the fresh sea air and woodland walks. Heading past the house into Kinneil Wood. A pleasurable walk along some serene woodland trails. After leaving the forest and the town behind, I moved further south, towards Linlithgow Bridge. The birds wandered aimlessly, as if searching for someone, standing guard by a lone seat that now lay empty. Next stop is the banks of the River Avon and the Avon Viaduct. An impressive, imposing structure that carries one of the main Edinburgh to Glasgow railway lines. You also pass the Avon Lagoon, a popular wild swimming spot. This route is part of the Avon Heritage Trail, a riverside walk from Avon Bridge to Linlithgow Bridge. It's a nice walk on its own, but it can be a wee bit muddy in places. Following the trail eventually lifts you from the riverside and onto the Union Canal, West Lothian's worthy epicentre of walking routes. The aqueduct marks the end of the West Lothian section of the John Muir Way. A great walk from start to finish, with a lot to see. If you don't fancy doing the whole route, there are plenty of mini adventures along the way. You'll find some of my favourites in the description below. Thanks everybody for watching. Remember to hit subscribe for future adventures, and I shall see you all next time.